Hi everyone, and welcome to our very first episode of Behind the Settings. I'm João, Senior PX Specialist at CD Projekt Red, and with me today I have Cezary Bella, our graphics programmer,
hey.
And Jakub Knapik, Global Art Director.
Hey.
Today we're going to be talking about the technical aspects of Cyberpunk 2077, giving you a peek under the hood. We're going to start by talking about the DLSS 3 update that came out at the end of January, and later I'll be joined by Giovanni de Francesco, our senior technical lighting artist. All right, so let's get started. Thank you for being here. We know that the latest update brought DLSS 3 and NVIDIA Reflex support to Cyberpunk 2077. And while of course players can already see the difference and they have already seen how it improves their performance, I thought that maybe we should go over it, explain for those who are not super familiar what this technology is and what it does. So let's take a step back and first start with DLSS 2. Can you maybe explain to us what it is and how it works?
Absolutely, but let me start with the explaining the name itself, because what DLSS stands for is actually Deep Learning Supersampling, which just by examining the name, we can actually say that it's an AI-based anti-aliasing algorithm, right? But we all know that it's more than that, because it does an upscaling job under the hood. And what the upscaling is just a bit of technology that allows us to render the frame in a lower resolution, gaining the performance while still maintaining the high-level details of a frame.
Of course, while you can still benefit from the upscaler in DLSS 2, what I think really is the game changer here in DLSS 3 is AI frame generation, and that's where I think players will see and are seeing the biggest performance. Can you maybe explain what is an AI-generated frame, and how does it generate those frames to begin with?
As you already said, DLSS 3 is actually AI-based frame generation, which captures some of our internal textures, and whenever the game wants to present the frame, it just takes over, stores our internal original frame into the copy, and then presents the generated one, right? And then there's a frame pacer thread that actually know exactly how long the frame should be, waits half of this time, and then presents the original frame generated by the game.
I think what's also very important here is, guys, that the system is actually analyzing the movement of every single pixel on the frame, and it creates an additional data that, using that information about the movement of the pixel, can actually generate smartly the right final image that perfectly blends between these two frames when it's being added. So you never feel like there's something jittery, or you never feel something that's off in a motion. It's always perfectly smooth and perfectly aligned between the frames. So that's why it's always super smooth, even if you're generating a totally new frame in between on top.
Okay, but then if you have an AI-generated frame inserted between two render frames that need to be compared, that means we can expect a higher input lag, and why NVIDIA Reflex was so important in this update as well, right?
Right, because actually enabling the NVIDIA Reflex is so important on that end, because it actually moves the time when we're querying the input from the players and shortens the gap between querying the input and then presenting the final frame.
Yeah, I think it's also important to say that this lag, this gap between the input and the frame is more noticeable when you have 30 frames per second than you say have 90 frames per second or 100 frames per second. So the technology becomes more important for those situations. And obviously, if you have 90 frames per second or 100 frames per second, unless you're a super pro player, then where every single microsecond means something for you as a player, you will never notice it anyway. So I think it's also important to say that, yeah, it's also dependent on the situation where you actually notice that.
Well, of course, anyone with a GPU that supports DLSS 3 can make use of it and see the performance improvement. I feel like this technology is really aimed at those players who really want to push their settings, really see, like, you know, that push that ray tracing to max, play it at 4K. Can you maybe talk a little bit about that? Like, who can benefit the most here? Like, what setups are aimed at?
It's a good question, actually. I think the biggest benefit of DLSS 3 is when you're actually pushing your quality and GPU power to the limits. So your frame rate is actually getting lower, and then you can generate two times more frames per second to cover up for it. So it's for extremely demanding visually content that normally requires more time to generate frame, but also for super, super high resolution screens like 4K, 8K, which maybe in the future becomes a standard. Then you actually, with 8K screen, you have four times more pixels to render than the 4K screen. It's not two times more, it's four times more. So it's actually four times slower. So if you're saying, if you say have normally 60 frames per second with 8K screen, you naturally have 1/4 of that. Someone can make math. So DLSS will actually make it just two times less, which is quite amazing because you'll get 30 frames per second on 8K screen.
All right, Kuba, Cezary, thank you so much for having this talk with me. I really appreciate it. I'm sure like players at home are really enjoying this update and yeah.
Thank you.
Okay, thanks a lot.
Now we're joined by Giovanni de Francesco, our senior technical lighting artist. Did I get that right?
Yeah, right.
It's a really long title. We are going to be talking about what's coming with patch 162, ray tracing overdrive, aka path tracing. So first, let's maybe explain what is ray tracing and how hybrid ray tracing works, that it is what our game uses, right?
Yeah, we're using actually hybrid ray tracing, I'll explain why it is that way. In general, ray tracing is a technology to calculate the light by just tracing exactly how it traveled through the world. And it's obviously way more accurate than using the more classical systems that were used in the past. We call it rasterizing rendering mode. But the hybrid mode is actually replacing some of the systems that together generate the frame and replaces them with ray traced elements. So imagine it that it's like layers in a Photoshop. To create a final image to the renderer in a game, you're actually generating layers of information from the world. So you're getting information about shadows, about the light that hit the surface, about the light that bounced from the surface, about the light that bounced from the shiny surfaces, all sort of information like that. And in classical old school rendering, you're doing that by individual subsystems that generate it separately, totally separately. So they have no information about the other systems. It's like throwing a lot of people together information about the world. They don't talk together at all. But generally the information they're gathering is imperfect. We call it approximation of reality. So they gather some blips of the information around it because it's quicker this way. And we combine it and that's the frame. That's how we do it. With hybrid ray tracing, we replace some of those guys with really accurate tracing. So bits of that information are very, very, very precise. And we're picking carefully which elements are very important, like reflections, like shadows, or like
global illumination
or ambient occlusion, because they add a lot of detail because they're more precise. So with hybrid rendering, we're just replacing some individual layers with more accurate ones.
Well, I will say that I know I'm a bit biased, but I feel like Cyberpunk 2077 is one of the most beautiful games that I've ever seen. The lighting, the city, the atmosphere, everything. And I know that path tracing is going to make the game look even more impressive. Can you maybe talk to us about what is path tracing and how is it different from what we already have in the game?
I'll just say, before I'd like Giovanni to hear what he wants to say, but in general, remember I talked about like multiple people gathering information from the world and they don't talk to each other. So the outcome that we're getting from those guys is inaccurate. Let's put it like this. It looks good, but in some cases, in some complex cases, it's not really what there should be bringing us. And with path tracing, we're just replacing a bunch of people who don't talk to each other into one guy, actually two guys. They just do it all. So there are no multiple people who don't talk. We just have two guys. One is responsible for information of the light hitting the surface, and the other guy is controlling all the information of the light that bounced off from the surface. And it's just two of these guys are gathering information from the world. So that's the biggest difference. We call it unified rendering. So it's a proper full ray tracing rendering.
Yeah, what can I add? I mean, that's pretty flawless.
Well, maybe can you tell us a bit of some of the locations, some of the weather conditions where players will really be able to see how this technology shines?
Well, I think when you will enable path tracing, you actually will see the difference everywhere. Is outside in the open world or is it interior, some location, you will actually see the difference. This is just the light behaving in a more realistic way. It's just the correct physics of lighting, right? So you see it, and the global illumination is completely different from what we have done in the past. It's very physically correct, and this will be mind-blowing.
I mean, I'm sure it wasn't easy because saying that like this is how correctly the light behaves, it's not an easy process to do. Can you maybe talk to us about some of the challenges, some of the processes of introducing this technology to Cyberpunk?
Well,
where I start?
Well, a challenge is for sure, make our old rendering and this new system make talk together. Because when you place when we place a light in the scene, it's still a light that works with the old system, right? Yeah. And when you implement this system, this light is seen in a completely new way. For example, we have now the chance to let every light cast shadow. Like, no matter if we have 100, 1,000 light, every light will cast shadow. And I think this is the first time ever in video games that something like this happened, because, it was not possible before.
Yeah, previously, right. Just to unpack, 100% with Giovanni, previously we had a limitation of 10 lights per game.
Shadow, no light.
Shadow for light. So you could have more lights, but only 10 were casting shadows. Practically right now, all the lights you see in the screen, all lights, it can be a thousand of lights, they will all cast fully realistic, soft shadow in the world, which is, plus all the emissive surfaces, like all the bright things we have behind us, will actually also cast a proper light and shadow. So this is really realistic way of treating the light this time around.
I mean, I think the best way to really understand it is a more comprehensible form of ray tracing, which then it means that it is going to be more performance heavy, right? Can you comment a bit about that? Like, what can players expect in terms of performance?
Well, it's going to be pretty expensive, pretty heavy on the GPU. And we don't have a precise number, but probably something around 30% heavier. Are 40% heavier, but this is where DLSS 3 come in to help us, because it gives back all the performance, all the frame that we are losing with this high demanding rendering technique.
Right, so DLSS 3 is really important for this technology, right?
Absolutely, like Giovanni said, there are two reasons for it. Like, number one reason is obviously that it helps to bump up the performance of the frame, so yeah, you're losing some frames per second with the more performant heavy technique of rendering, but you make it up with the frame generation by the DLSS 3. But there's one more thing that comes very important with the DLSS 3 frame generation for path tracing actually. The difference in the calculating the frame between more classical hybrid ray tracing technique and the path tracing technique is that the detail in the hybrid mode is a little bit less dependent on the resolution, because a lot of the calculations are happening independently of the resolution. While with path tracing, sheer amount of pixels on the screen equals the final detailing and the quality of the calculation of the lighting. So in short, you actually want to have as many pixels on the screen as possible to get as good definition of the world as possible. So that way you can actually, because the DLSS is actually allowing you to control the quality, so how much you're upscaling the image. So with the frame generation, you can actually push yourself to have a little bit higher quality of the base image before upscaling, because you're generating frames to make up for it. So what I'm trying to say is that it's really, really a perfect match in a way, the DLSS 3 and the path tracing.
Kuba, Giovanni, thank you so much for our talk today. Is there anything you want to add and tell our players?
Oh, actually, yes. Just be sure to update your driver.
Yes, please update your drivers.
Yeah, you should have a pretty powerful GPU anyway. Otherwise, try just to lower the resolution and it's gonna run. In some way.
Yeah, I think it's also a moment to say that, guys, we're releasing it as a technology preview. It's very important that we're doing it like this, because it's not some bump or update of one of the filters or elements in the game. It's literally a totally new way of rendering the game. And obviously, the game is massive, and the technology change is huge. So we're calling it technology preview. So yes, there could be some issues here and there, but we'll still keep investing into this. We're still working on this one, and we hope to kind of smooth it out and wrap it up for the proper next release in the future. But for now, we're giving you like a preview of what we think is the future of rendering. And I think at the same time, we'd like to thank NVIDIA and our programmers who put a lot of effort into making this happen. And we really hope that you guys enjoy it and like it, like we actually do right now.
We're having fun.
Yeah, we're having fun working on this.
It's super cool.
Yeah, personally, I cannot wait to see it and test it myself. I also cannot wait to see some of the pictures that our players are going to take, because I'm sure they're going to be fantastic. Thank you again.
Thank you.
So that's it for us today. Don't forget, you will be able to check path tracing with the upcoming patch 1.62 coming soon. And please let us know if you enjoy this type of content, would like to see more, and I'll see you next time.
Yeah.
Thank you.